Alisa, I stopped leash reactivity, pulling, cat reactivity, jumping, play biting, counter surfing, taking toys and food away from kids.
Holy shit.
Chewing, digging, resource guarding, eating trash. Thank you.
All from our free videos?
Wow.
Wow, look at that.
That's so great.
That's cool. Thank you. Congratulations. We are live. Is it Saturday night? Mm-hmm. Saturday night. Hey, everybody. How are you? Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Jeff Welcome Gellman to the Solid show. Volume works. Good. Hey, I got no problem. You always got to test it out. The one time that the microphone didn't work, now we got to test it every single time.
Yeah.
Hey, everybody. How are you? I'm so happy that you're all here. This is Joelle. She's one of the trainers at the training center. She'll also see all of my seminars. And then she also is responsible for a lot of the social media that we put up as far as the content creation that we're putting up. So glad to always have her during the show. She's also probably the company official laugher. So she's got the best laugh of the company. She beats everybody 10 to 1 on that one. Yeah. And maybe we'll see a little bit of that tonight. We'll see. This is a 90-minute show. We do these shows 3 times a week. Let's see. I did a quick pop-up YouTube live today. I'm going to try to tweak those, and I think I want to do more of those. I think I'm going to do those often, actually. Just thoughts in my head. I want to get them up there. I'm also starting to put new content up on the Patreon channel, too. It's a little bit different, some stuff that you won't be able to see anywhere else. This is a Q&A show, just like my seminars. I travel the world doing dog training seminars. We're doing 25 this year. They're 2-day seminars around North America. 2020 schedule is in the works already. We're already planning international ones. The gist of the show, the gist of my seminars is solving. How to stop behaviors. That's the gist of it. That's what I personally specialize in. That's what the training center specializes in. We're really great with rehabilitating aggressive dogs, anxious dogs, leash reactive dogs, dogs that redirect, some of the worst behaviors that a dog could possibly have. Shut down nervous, fearful dogs. Obviously, we train a lot of basic obedience. We deal with young puppies. In fact, we're launching a trick training puppy class, puppy socialization class, and nose work class. We're actually redoing one of our training rooms. It's going to be our new training room just for more one-on-ones and those select classes, group classes as well. So that's exciting. That'll be probably a lot of that'll be done while we're gone, actually. I think I'm going to make sure that they've got all the supplies they need while we're gone. We're leaving next Thursday night for a 12-day road trip, and we'll make sure that they get, if they have time, you know. Yeah. I mean, they will, though. The folks that are doing that don't have time. So what you'll do is you ask your questions. Thank you for all the folks that are doing the top chat, the super chats. Really appreciate that. If you're not familiar with what I do, you're going to hear the word punishment a lot. The reason why is because almost every question at my seminar, everyone brings me these dogs. All the questions on the show tonight, the podcast, are how do I stop? How do I stop? How do I stop? There's only one way to stop an unwanted behavior as far as the concepts. It's apply a punisher. That's it. Now, people need to be educated on what that means. And that's what we're here for. Let's always remember, whenever you apply a punisher to a dog, you are not mad. You are not angry. You are not upset. You're not yelling. You're not screaming. You don't even need to raise your voice. You actually can just say no and apply the punisher. It's actually more effective that way. So if you're brand new, that's why we talk a lot about that. For anybody out there that's convinced or preaches that you only have to reward a dog in order to get it to stop an unwanted behavior, well, unfortunately, you're either mistaken or an outright liar and fraud. So you might just not know. You just might not know the information. But there are people out there that know the information and are lying about it. That makes you unethical and a fraud. And we'll just have none of that on the show. So here we go. Joelle's going to start with the questions. And let's go. And we also don't have Melissa coming.
So, okay. Yes. Nate gave you a thumbs up.
Hey, thanks, Nate.
Baker's Acres Canine Academy. Hey, everyone. Evening, Jeff and Joelle. Shout out to Linda and the kids.
Awesome. Linda's been in bed now for day 2. So she's getting a little bit better. So thank you so much. And Romy's sick tonight.
Oh my God. I'm going to get sick.
Yes. No, house. You won't. No. Next.
Hostwe, have an awesome show. Heart you both.
Thank you.
Tom Size Vlogs. Hey, Jeff. Hey, Joelle. Got a shock collar for my dog and is a 900-yard collar. Works great. Seeing results already. I was hesitant on getting it, but you've got me convinced.
Awesome. So yeah, a little bit more than a half a mile, which is fine. Tom, the reason why you most likely were hesitant is because you didn't want to hurt your dog. Neither do I, right? I don't want to hurt your dog. I don't want to hurt my dogs. I don't want to hurt my client dogs. But that's why people hesitate to do it. But we find that most people that are not using tools are actually creating more discomfort, harm, both physical and mental to their dogs as well as themselves. So the lack of tools will actually really fucks the tuyas up, you know, next.
The tuyas. Yep. Alexia, hello guys. I was having trouble downing my dog. She always hesitates. I watched your video. It worked like a charm. Now she drops instantly. Thanks, Jeff. You rock.
Awesome. Proud of you. That's great. You found a free video. You implemented it. Life is good. Not bad.
Nice. Mighty Pickle. I love that name. If considering using a bark collar, does age of the dog matter or can you use on any age? Dog is 12.
Do you own a barking dog? Well, there you go. There's your answer. Nope. Doesn't matter to me. Dog training is related to behavior. So you have a barking dog that's 12. I wouldn't use one on a 12-week-old puppy. But from 16 to 18 weeks older, damn right I would. Next.
Leesboro, Judy, watching with Dickens while grooming him.
Nice. Did you move the grooming table into the training center yet?
No.
Tomorrow we'll do that.
We like literally worked up until the end of the day. Sure. Mighty Pickle, exhibiting separation anxiety, won't stop howling and barking when left alone.
Get yourself a bark. Well, first of all, watch by separate.
She's the one who just asked about the bark collar. It's the same dog.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Next. But hold on. Sorry. But also watch my separation anxiety video on YouTube. Next.
Michelle, good evening, Jeff and
Joel. Hey, Michelle, how are you? Number one commenter on YouTube.
Mm-hmm. Rescues and focused dog training. I know this may sound silly.
Nope.
But could you tell me an appropriate way to hold two leashes when walking two dogs? I also have the two-dog system e-collar now.
You can do two separate leashes, one in each hand, which is going to be a little bit more complicated. You just put them – or you put them – both in the same hand, you take your leash, you loop it up, not around your hand, you just loop it up, and you just hold them both like this. Next.
Caitlin, good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Hey, Caitlin.
Hey, Caitlin.
Donde, hello, how are you today?
Things are fantastic. How are you?
I'm great.
Awesome.
Yeah. Jess, hi, Jeff. How do I get my Malamute to calm when playing? She seems to throw up every time she plays with other dogs from being overexcited.
You might be working her too hard, you know. You might be working her too hard. I mean, I usually let dogs play rough. So what I would do is give her like stop her, put her into a down, send her back out, things like that. Next.
Rescues and focused dog training. I hold the end on my thumb and then I fold the leash in half for now.
You can do that too. Whatever is the most comfortable for you. Next. Just remember when you're walking your dogs, hold your leashes like bicycles and down like this. Because if you're holding your leash like this, it's a weird movement. Next.
Kaylee J, hey Jeff and Joelle, took Arlo for his first swim of the year today. Excited for the show tonight. Much love to you both.
Kaylee J.
Is it just snowing there? Like,
yeah, but that dog can swim. I swim my dogs in the winter.
What?
Yeah.
Where?
In the ocean.
Wow.
Yeah, they don't care.
I wouldn't do that with my dogs.
Wes would go swimming.
Oh, he would. I just wouldn't do it.
Well, that's you. If I took him, he would. Next.
Later, Ron. Good morning from Aussie.
Hey, how are you? I'm going to try to get over to Brisbane next.
Lisa. Hey, excited for next weekend. Although I've lived in New Jersey my whole life and I've never heard of Mantua. LOL.
You know what? Until we booked that seminar, either did I. And up until 3 weeks.
Are we even saying it right?
Manta.
I'm sure.
I'm calling it Manta.
The U. You know why? First, though. No. It's not AU.
Because there's a Mantauk. Mantauk.
That's AU.
Oh, so I'm not just saying the K. Anyway, we're going to be in New Jersey. So thank you. Working spots are sold out. Audit spots. Actually, we just sold another one today. Audit spots are still. Yeah. Nice. Still selling. It's going to be a good one. We're creeping up to over 40 people with that one. It's going to be a fantastic seminar. Snacks that are free. Next.
Patricia, happy Easter, Jeff and Joelle and everyone. Greetings from the land down under.
Oh, happy Easter to you as well. Next. A lot of us. Australia is huge, by the way, for us. You know, in all my analytics, like Australia shows up. Yeah.
Do a seminar.
Yep. I'm trying to get to Brisbane. Next.
Sheila, my German Shepherd will not stop biting her tail. Looks like it's a two-parter, but I don't know where the rest
Okay.
Is.
So what I would do is, biting the tail, remote collar, dog bites the tail, make it suck to bite the tail. Next.
Susan, when pre-screening clients, do you ever decline a family because they aren't able to do the follow-through afterwards? Client schedules are too busy?
100% of the time. Yeah. It's not about the work we do. It's about the work they will be doing. I was just talking to my buddy Sean about that. I probably turn away conservatively $5,000 a week worth of business. Literally, these are people that, see, this is the thing. If I really wanted to like do another $250,000 a year, I would just take every client and we would do a great job. And then whatever happened, happened. But we don't do that in our company. We want everybody to win. But I turn away $5,000 easily. I mean, some weeks I do more. Some weeks I turn away two boarding trains because I don't feel they're the right client. And I try to help them out. And then so many times I just tell you, I'd be like, don't send your dog to me. This is how you fix it. Or don't send your dog to me. Do a Skype. Or, you know, watch your videos, obviously. Next.
Kara, not sure about what size prong to use on my DSD. She's 2, husky size, I'd say. I feel like I have just a few prongs with a 3, but the 2.5 doesn't seem to be super effective.
No.
Thick fur, help.
German Shepherd would be 3 millimeter. Next. Just remember, it's supposed to be super snug. Next.
Christopher, Jeff, thanks for all your help. My 5-month-old puppy has gotten aggressive about high-value treats, bones, usually the cat around, but also my wife. We took the bone to figure out what to do.
Teach that dog out. 5-month-old dog, teach that dog out. So I've got a video on that. What you'll do is you put the bone on the ground, remote collar on the dog. If you don't have a remote collar, you'll use the bonker. You'll say out, use the remote, dog backs away. High level. Next.
Karen, should I punish if my dog gets excited when someone she knows comes close when we are walking and she starts to bark?
Karen? Would you, let me ask you a question and then I'll let you answer it. Would you like that behavior to stop? Would you like that behavior to continue? And the lack of no is always yes. In other words, the lack of no is a reward. Top chat, $4.99, Lauren Gibson. 1 year Ellie, leash reactive and dog aggressive. 3 year Maggie can be, okay. It's don't write in code on these guys.
1 year Ellie, that's
a
dog.
Yes, leash reactive and dog aggressive. And there's a second dog. Maggie can be aggressive with people. Been working with them to correct the prong and shot collar. Okay. So Lauren, just remember, it's a multi-phased protocol for rehabbing aggression. Everything matters. Everything matters. Always remember that. Everything matters. So what happens is every little bit. So take away all affection. All free roaming, massive structure, crate at night, crate when you're not home, everything permission-based. Absolutely hold the dog accountable for things. Next.
Christopher, this is with the resource guarder. He said she's already learned out command for her food.
Okay, this is different. You make it fucking suck. If I had a dog at 5 months old or any age, but especially 5 months old that young, that tried to guard something or bite me, I assure you they would never do it again. They would never want to do it again. Guys, if you own dogs, and don't do this switch out stuff. That's the biggest bunch of fucking bullshit in the world. This exchange. Dog growls over a bone. Offer it some hot dogs. You really want to train an aggressive dog? That's how you do it. That's how you train aggression. Hell no. Everybody that owns a dog better be ready to read that dog the riot act at least once in its life. But the thing is, you're not mad. You're not angry. You're not upset. It's just matter of fact. You make that suck beyond belief. Next. Oh, $4.99 top chat. Lauren, been making progress today. Out on a run. A dog got loose and attacked us. Fuck, that's going to set your training back. Bit Ellie in the rump. Only scratches, 1 puncture. How do I proceed? First of all, hopefully you kick the shit out of that dog. Oh my God, Jeff, you're so violent. Really? Like, I would hope we would all protect our dogs. So, you know, any dog comes close to us like that, no. You neutralize that threat. Number one, your dog could die. Your dog could get serious injuries. You could get bit. But the training definitely got set back. So what do? Keep it up. Next.
Ryan, any advice to stop excitement stress pee with a 4-month-old puppy?
4-month, 16-week-old puppy. This is what we do. First of all, how do you know it's stress? Don't be throwing that fucking stress card in there. All right. That could be a false assumption. Excitement and stress. Which one is it? Can we have both? Can you be excited and stressed at the same time? Maybe, but let's get stress out of there. Somebody told you that or you read that somewhere. All right. So a lot of people are miscategorizing fear in their dogs when it's just like being a dog. So what we do is this: massive structure, massive amounts of structure. All right. Watch your excitement levels. Outsides for excitement, insides for calmness. Everything's permission based. All the stuff we would do normally do with the 16-week-old puppy. We just see those stuff organically go away. Next.
Kara, having a hard time keeping my dog from trying to get ahead of me on the walk. She will even walk with her head turned into me to try to get her feet ahead. Prong pops don't seem to get the message.
Take your left foot, heel tap into the chest. Next.
Crixis. Good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey.
Jeff, had a good laugh at your expense. Came across your epic fail on a little kid's bike. To your credit.
Oh my gosh.
The dog was at I think that may have been when I liked one of the first videos I ever saw on YouTube.
I know.
I bet that was a long ride home.
I had a black
eye. That was a mean
so that, black eye. That was, I actually, it got to the point where this eye was so, I forgot. One of my eyes was so swollen shut. It was forcing my other eye to shut. I was in the fucking RV
so
by
bad.
Myself from Canada driving home.
It was like purple.
I know. I know.
Courtney, hey guys, I babysit dogs in my house. Is it ethical to use a bonker on dog boarding if I have to, or should I consult the owner on correcting their dogs first?
Thanks. You don't consult the owner. You tell the owner what you're going to do. Full disclosure, absolutely. You let them know that you, if your dog barks, these are the things you might have to do. Absolutely. Have everything fully disclosed. We do. You tell, Jeff, you tell owners you bonk their dogs. We teach owners how to bonk their dogs. Mm-hmm. If we have an aggressive dog that we have to choke out, which rarely happens, the owner is going to learn how to do that too. It's their dog. Everybody needs to learn how to handle their own dog. So we absolutely have full disclosure. Next. And we demonstrate all this stuff in my seminars live. Hey, knock it off. Come here. Here? Nope. Kira. Something's going on in that fucking hallway. Next.
Kaylee J. Yeah, snowstorm a little over 2 weeks ago. Today it hit almost 80 degrees.
I know.
Wow. Amethyst. Hey, guys. My dog listens to my commands, but not my husband's. I'm not sure what he's doing different. The dog just goes grade A asshole on him and just doesn't listen to him. What can we do? Just
have your husband start from the beginning. You get out of the room or you stay in the room and coach your husband, but don't do it for him and don't backseat dog train. Start from the beginning. He might not have the same skill set as you. He might not have the same timing as you. All right. What's all the noise out there, Angelo?
All right.
You're not wearing any pants?
He just laughs about it. He's like, no.
Just like you, Papa.
Good night.
Good night, Angela.
Okay, say good night to YouTube Live.
Good night, YouTube Live.
He had me rolling the other day. His jokes at the center. He cracks me up. Jess, we have a 10-month-old female male and are getting her a male brother. One of the Malamutes we are looking at has separation anxiety. Could she help him overcome it since she doesn't have it?
No, she'll probably, your other dog will probably get it. Don't let your dogs train dogs. You train the dog. I would suggest you don't get one, that one. But then again, all depends on your skill set. You need to know how to stop separation anxiety. If you know how to stop separation anxiety, then get the dog. If you don't know how to do it, don't let your dog do it. Next.
Danny, just call it a deterrent. People are so brainwashed and might fly.
Deterrent instead of what? Punisher?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck no. I'm saying it's a punisher. I'm using the proper dog training terminology that the snowflakes have covered up. The snowflakes have covered up. It's a punisher. It needs to be called what it is. People have to stop cringing and throwing the abuse card out there in a word that has nothing to do with it. Has nothing to do with it. All right? So if I get caught speeding and I get fined, I've been punished. I wouldn't call that abuse at all. Next.
Elisa, when passing by supermarket windows on walks, 9-month-old Malamute stops in his tracks and pulls backwards on prong collar, whining loudly. Same behavior at pet store or vet entrance. Suggestions?
Okay. Walking by the grocery store, just pop. So just say heel and do pop, pop. All right. And then going in the vet store, the vet entrance and the pet store, role play that back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Again, pop, pop. Next.
Although, hi, Jeff, Joelle, any tips on how to stop sniffing when walking in a loose leash? Did fine on a short leash.
Well,
I would like to use a looser
okay,
leash.
Okay. Loose leash does not mean like 2-3 feet of leash. Loose leash to me means just no tight leash. But it could be a short leash. So dog in a proper heel next to you only needs that much leash. And it's not taut. I mean, if it's a short dog, it needs a little bit more. But if you think loose leash walking is a dog out in front of you, you're asking the dog to sniff. That's how our tracking dogs work. So keep the dog next to you, head next to you. You don't need a long leash, but it's still considered we call it loose leash walking because the leash is loose. Next.
I don't know why it's always so hard to say.
I know.
Loose leash. Carrie. E-collar prong structured walk with reactive Great Dane. She will now correct arousal with verbal no, but wants to avoid. Do I accept that? How do I get her to ignore and be calm?
Wait, hold on. She wants to avoid?
Yes. She will now correct arousal with verbal no, but wants to avoid. Do I accept that? How do I get her to ignore and be calm?
But she's avoiding it. She is being calm and accept it. I don't understand the question.
I guess maybe instead of avoid, like she doesn't want the dog to like go into avoidance. She wants her to stay.
Right. Okay. But right now, avoidance is the segue. So if you're struggling with alcohol addiction, you can't walk into the bar because you can't control yourself. So is the goal to walk into a restaurant or a bar that serves alcohol and not drink? That's the goal. Right now, if you have to stay out of the bar or the restaurant and don't go on, don't sit down at tables with people drinking alcohol, if that helps you deal with the rehab process, so be it. If I got you, really allow dogs to like move over a little bit and avoid. Next.
Donde, do you recommend training obedience all the days? We normally train in walks, but I like to train in home too.
No, it's, how about this? It's life. Life is obedience. Like every day of your life should be training. And that doesn't mean you have to do drills. It means what are you guys doing with your dogs? Like, aren't you, when you're home, aren't your dogs like in place or in a down somewhere? When you take them for walks, aren't they healing? When you're playing with them, don't you throw them into a sit and then throw the ball, put them into a down and then throw the ball? Don't you tell them to go into their kennels and be quiet? Like every day is training. Every day is training. Next.
Scattered Storm would love to stick around, but I got to go. Awesome points.
Watch the replay.
Nicole, any tips for teaching your dog to hold his bladder and tips for excessive licking? My 6-month-old puppy licks everything.
Yeah, you correct that with a remote collar. As far as holding its bladder, you make sure you crate train your dog and don't take your dog out so often. Put it in duration and put it on a time schedule. Keep an Excel spreadsheet about the time. Next.
Cassandra, what are some of the signs you look for to read a dog's intent to figure out if they're aggressive versus reactive?
Well, aggressive versus reactive, you find out what their past behavior has been. Okay? So intent, you wouldn't know the intent until they actually did something. So most aggression is just not, is most people misdiagnose aggression. So in other words, if I've got a dog in a downstay and another dog walks by and it's just loading on that dog, now that dog might just react to it or try to attack it. But if the owner tells me, or if I've seen it attack it, I'll know what that is. But I always assume the dog's going to pick the worst behavior if it's picked the worst behavior in the past. Next.
Later on, Brisbane sounds good. Perth would be better.
If I can get enough people to do Perth, Perth is fine. And Perth allows tools. Right now, you guys are trying to pass some crazy law there with no dogs not in a crate longer than 2 hours, no prong cowers, and no shock cowers. Great. You better want to put it. You guys in Perth in the Western Australia, put a kibosh on that. Mm. Put a kibosh on that right away. Right away. Next.
Tony, what led you to train dogs?
I told this story many times, just like most dog trainers out there. I had a really badly behaved dog that nobody can help. Next.
Donde, at this point, I can hit really hard a dog if it comes to attack us.
Good, as you should. Sucks for the dog, but good for you and your dog and possibly your family. Next.
Baker's Acres Canine Academy. We recently got jumped by a dog on a walk as well. I hit that dog with a chuck it stick and he ran back across the street with his tail between his legs. Owner got right in my face and I told him to F off.
Yep. Carry some mace and spray the owner. Spray the owner. So at first you were attacked by a dog, you neutralized the threat, and then you were attacked by the owner. Typical bully. Typical entitled bully. Spray him right in the face, kick him in the nuts, drop him to the ground. And I'm not a violent person. I mean, it might seem like it tonight, but it's like, you come into my space. It's like, what are all these people doing? Like, what are these people doing? Running up to people and yelling at them for because they didn't control their dog. If my dog ever runs up to somebody and goes after their dog or jumps on them, and if that person kicks my dog, shame on me. My fault. It's my fault. It is 100% my fault. I can't be mad at the owner. I can't be mad at my dog. I'm the asshole that didn't do a good enough fucking job training my dog. I'm going to open up a window. I'm listening to you.
Getting all fired up.
No, it's just warm in here.
You want me to read the next one? No, go ahead. Master Mahan, what do you think about people getting dogs just to get the dogs famous online?
Oh, I don't know. I don't give a shit. You know, I mean, is that, you know, how are they as dog caretakers? All I care about is, are they doing a good job training and taking care of their dog? I don't care. If they want to get a dog to pick up fucking chicks, get a dog. I don't care. I mean, if you want to get a dog to get laid, get a dog to get laid. It's like, what are you doing with the, all I care about is, are you training the dog? Are you giving the dog a good quality of life? I really don't care. There's so many fucking dogs in shelters. Pull them out of there. I don't give a shit what you do with them. As long as you fucking don't, you know, as long as you give them a good quality of life. Next.
Caitlin, I live in an apartment complex with elevators and I would like your advice on how to stop my dog's reactive behaviors when somebody comes into the elevator with their dogs on retractable leashes. Oof.
Well, what I would do is this. I would talk to management, have them send out a memo on proper elevator etiquette with dogs, and that all dogs need to be next to owners and in full control. Or guess what? Every apartment building has a staircase. They're more than welcome to freaking work their cardio in. So, but as far as your dog, you know, even if it wasn't on a retractable, your dog still might react to it. How do you do it? The way you stop any other reactivity. What I do with elevators, I walk into an elevator, I look to the right, look to the left, whichever space is open, I walk to that space, my dog goes up against the wall, I stand next to my dog, so it's wall, dog, me, and then the rest of the elevator. Next.
Kara, my e-collar was stolen by another trainer, now I just have a sport dog. Save money for a new e-collar or go to your seminar in Canton?
You can... Depends what, okay, if your dog is on punishment level, I can use a sport dog. So if you need an e-collar technology one, I mean, I've got them in Canton, but don't wait till then. Buy one on Amazon. Just buy one on Amazon. But depends what level your dog is. I don't train commands on a sport dog. They run a little bit hot for me, but I have no problem using it just for a trained dog for correction only. Next.
Katie, my almost 4-year-old daughter had a whole ream of paper on the floor and was rolling them into tubes with blocks inside. I asked what she was doing, and she said they were bonkers.
Tell your daughter we don't put blocks inside. Tell her to use cotton towels next time. Next. Tell your daughter I've got a free video on YouTube she can watch, and I don't think I swear in it, too. So next.
Blair, hello from Canada. Excited for Collingwood. Are there spots left?
You'd have to go to – ooh, you know what? Yes, there's spots left. I just checked the other day. There's like at least one working spot left. I'm pretty sure there's at least one working spot left. Our seminars are selling out months in advance, guys. And I never like to try to like buy it now. It's going to sell out. But they do. They just sell out, especially working spots. So go to jeffgellmanseminars.com. I'm running 25 seminars. I know I'm not keeping track of them all. I know the one we've got coming up this weekend, working spots have been sold out for a long time. Elkhart, Indiana. I think there's still a couple left. Next.
Cassandra, curious about when you have to choke a dog out?
If I have to break up a dog fight, that's it. It rarely happens because we don't have dog fights. If a dog was, here's a great example. It won't happen in my seminar. I'm sorry. It won't happen at my,
training center
because dogs don't fight there. And we have aggressive dogs. Say a dog was, but I was giving you an example with a client. Okay. Say a client wants to know, they've got two dogs in the house and one of the dogs attacks the other dog. And it's a serious dog fight where the dog is committed to the bite and the client wants to know how to break up the dog fight. I'll show them how to do it. We don't have to do that at our training center because we use electronics and muzzles. Next.
P. Gammon. Jeff, I've learned so much from your show. My 9-month-old boxer is doing so well. I've shared your channel with a couple of friends who are having puppy challenges. You guys are a great team.
Awesome.
That's great.
Next.
Callie, on walks, my dog will stare at the cars pretty intensely. He also scans for them to come by. While the cars approach, he tries to run away from them. But after they pass, he tries to run after them. How do I fix this?
He's on walks?
Yeah.
He's not walking. He's not in a proper heel next to you. That can't be done. Keep your dog next to you in a proper heel. So I'm assuming your dog's not next to you if he's got all that movement. So listen, who is that, Hallie? Hallie, if you've got your dog anywhere from 4 to 6 feet in front of you, you can't give your dog any information. Your dog's got all that room to do stupid stuff. So teach your dog how to properly heel, which is walking next to you at your pace, in your direction, no pulling, no marking, no sniffing, no turning right, no turning left, not head down the ground, head up. So watch my video on how to properly heel a dog. Yeah, but when you get your dog in front of you, that's not a dog walk to me. And you're going to struggle. You're going to struggle with that. Next.
Sunny, thanks, Jeff, for the advice on the state of mind and remote collar last session. Best walk in my life, even better than the bonker solo. My question here is at what point these tools are no longer needed?
The goal is not to get the dog off the tools. The goal is to make your life better. Getting the dog off the tools is not success. Making you happy every day is success. I'm not the dog trainer that tries to get dogs off tools at all. My dogs are off tools. Big deal. I'm a dog trainer. I've got a skill set. Also, my dogs only exhibit certain unwanted behaviors that are not dangerous. If I need, so I don't have to worry about some things. So, but most of our clients, though, why would you want to struggle? That's what I would ask. Now, in the house, that's reasonable. You probably don't need tools. Your dog should be underneath voice control in the house. Outside on a walk, outside off leash, use them forever. If your dog's on a leash, it has to be connected to something. Why not something that actually can give you the best communication? If your dog's off leash, how do you communicate with it when it's off leash? And how do you prepare for those what if moments? So, next.
Elisa, I stopped leash reactivity, pulling, cat reactivity, jumping, play biting, counter surfing, taking toys and food away from kids.
Holy shit.
Chewing, digging, resource guarding, eating trash. Thank you.
All from our free videos?
Wow.
Wow, look at that.
That's so great.
That's cool. Thank you. Congratulations.
She also says, hoping for a seminar in United Arab Emirates.
So, Elisa, I would love to get to the EU.
Yeah.
I would love to get to the EU. In fact, is Dubai in the EU?
It is.
Okay, so I can do a seminar in Dubai.
Yeah.
So I can. I have a location in Dubai.
It's, do you?
Yeah.
Are we doing Dubai?
No. I don't know if I can pull a seminar off there. Alyssa, if you think you can pull a seminar, help me pull a seminar off there. I have a location. So I have a location already. All right. It's at a major hotel over there. It's in a major hotel, so let me know.
Humidity's getting in my hair, this show, man.
I know.
Lisa, I feel it getting bigger. Can you bring a 2.25 prong for me to buy next week?
Yeah, we always have them with us. No problem. Next.
Robert, do you know if the e-collar is safe for an epileptic dog?
I can only vouch for e-collar technologies and Dogtra. Next.
Lauren, tips for walking past fence dog. My dog is leash reactive. I try to correct early and keep walking, but still escalates, and she keeps lunging, barking. Won't listen to correction on high e-collar.
So what I want you to do is it's dog training. Use space. Start out using space. All right. And then work your way closer. Next. And also eliminate the arousal high at the very beginning of the reactivity. At the thought of it. Don't match the dog's reactivity. Overpower it. Next.
Brandy, is a bonker work for aggression towards people and animals?
Yeah, it's one of the things. It's not the only thing. So if you've got a dog that's aggressive towards people and animals, you need a major overhaul. It's one of the tools we use, but there's probably 100 things you need to do to eliminate those behaviors. That's just one tool that we use. We do so many protocols when it comes to aggression rehab. So that's where people should be doing Skype sessions with me, join my Patreon page, attend a seminar, do a board and train. But it's one thing. That's just one of the components. Next.
Blake, how do I train my wife to do tricks?
I don't know, usually jewelry or money, to be stereotypical, right? Next.
Patricia, would love you to be able to come to regional NSW. What is that? But understand completely, laws here already in place limiting use of tools.
South Wales.
Oh.
New South Wales, which is, it's the lower parts. I don't know if Sydney's in there or not, but it's you can't do this shit there.
Yeah, so it's backward thinking. Dogs and humans are paying for it.
Thank you, Patricia. I know they are. Yeah, Brisbane is about as low as I can go, I think. The Gold Coast. Brisbane's probably about as low as I can go. I'm just like trying to look at a map right now. I'm like, I'm looking at longitude and latitude lines, and I'm like, I'm looking at a map, and I see Sydney there, and I see New South Wales, and I'm seeing the little dotted line on the map, and then I see Brisbane right there, and
Where's my summer?
And Cairns is up there, and you know, so next.
Chevy, great to see your lovely faces again, guys. Hey Chevy, haven't seen you in a while. Holding on dog training. Hey guys. Woo. I made it to the show. Whatever I missed, I probably loved it. Love you guys.
You watch the replay. Hey,
Chevy says RV life with dog special.
Did you get setup. Lauren? Did you get Lauren?
No.
No.
Oh. Sorry. I did. Heard you talking about having a place in Bradenton. Any chance you'll ever do a seminar there in the future? Trying to make it to Charlotte, but Bradenton would be incredible.
I've got a couple places, two houses in Bradenton. I'm actually looking actively right now to buy another house. We might do one in Tampa. We might do one in Tampa, probably not till 2020. Get to Charlotte next.
Chevy, RV life with dogs, special crate setup, got three GSCs.
I've shown it. The new RV, yes. The new RV, I just bought a new RV about a month ago, and it has bunk beds in it. And so the bottom bunk, I've actually taken I took an X-Pen, mounted the X-Pen on the front of it, and made one of them a door. And the dogs go in there. So I've got it. They're in the bunk. They're out of the way. Next.
Crystal. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. Sitting here sewing up dog beds. Any tips for getting them to stop?
Get rid of them. While the dog is on them in your home, that's easy. The dog's not on them. How do you stop a dog from destroying a bed when nobody's there to correct it? That's a good question. Next.
Chevy, sold my house and thinking about RVing around New Zealand for the next wee while.
Oh, next. Now, your RVs over there are way smaller. They're way smaller over there. Your caravans are way smaller. So, you know, your crates, what you could always do is look for, you can do a couple of things. You can look for one of your vans. So the vans that they've got there, you get yourself like a Mercedes or you get yourself a Dodge. But even the other vans, what you can do is you're going to put the crates in the back and you're going to put your bed on top. All right. So the crates will actually end up being a platform, or they'll go underneath the platform for the bed. So that's what you're going to do. That's going to be probably your best setup. Next. They call that the basement of the van. Next.
Crystal, hi, Jeff and Joelle. Oh, I just read that. Sorry. Bertman, good day, Jeff and Joelle. Great show. Bloody snowflakes. I have prong and e-collar. I'm not giving them up for those weirdos. I'm in NSW. Yes, Sydney is in NSW.
Yeah, Bert, man. How you doing? Yeah, there are, put it this way, everywhere that tools are illegal, I'm put it this way, they're doing them. So I get hired and get from private people. So I had a client in Germany who flew me out to Germany. Now, these tools are illegal in Germany, and it's illegal for me to train in Germany. And I trained them and I trained their neighbors. And then I had people come in from other countries. I trained them. And guess what? They're all on shock collars. And we also use bandanas. So next.
Hey, Jeff's here. Better get over there to that neighbor's house.
Yeah, we had people from five countries, one-on-ones, all private one-on-ones that came in from five countries.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's Europe. It's easy to do.
Yeah. True. Just take the train.
Looks.
Susan, can at-home lessons at the client's house be as successful as board and trains in most situations, or at-home lessons only good for certain things?
I think a board and train is going to be much more successful for a lot of things, but it also depends on your skill set. It also depends on your, depends on your skill set. Next. It also depends on what your training style is. If you want to work on state of mind stuff, it's going to be hard for an at-home lesson because owners aren't going to know how to do a lot of duration state of mind work, where in a training center, like at our training center, we'll have dogs out in place beds for hours at a time. And most owners won't do that. Next.
Svenja.
Yep.
What do I do about my dog getting obsessive and protective over another dog? I sit once a month.
You have to apply a punisher. So I'm not quite sure what obsessive and protective over the other dog. Does that mean when you approach the dog, your dog guards it, or does your dog guard you? So I need a little bit more context. Help me out there, Svenja.
Nate, hey, got a new puppy, 1 year old, cries when I tie it up outside and go inside. Tips for stopping whining.
So Nate, that's not unusual, and nobody give this guy a hard time for tying him up outside because he doesn't have a fenced in yard, most likely. It's just a tie out. It's no big deal. What I would do, though, is this, Nate. Instead of doing that for now, you got a brand new dog, just take the dog for a walk around the backyard. Take him for a walk around the backyard to do potty time. Put him on a long line. Get yourself a 25-foot line. See if he likes to play fetch, chuck it, maybe some engagement stuff. Take him for structured walks. And that's sort of his outside time until you have a reliable recall. And then have them come inside and do duration work. Also, if you don't have a fenced in yard, if you don't own the property, you can't put one up. But if you don't have the budget for one, what you could do is you could always get, you know, a 5 foot high chicken wire, comes 100 feet to the roll for $65 at Home Depot. You get those green steaks at $8 to $9 a piece. Just make yourself a little bit of a pen. Make yourself a little bit of a pen. You know, the dog might be able to jump out of it. I'm not quite sure the size or the strength of the dog. But, you know, usually a lot of times dogs on a tie out station, they can sometimes whine, pull on it, lunge on it. So just be cautious about that. But right now, what I would do is I would do more engagement stuff and just don't leave them outside unsupervised right now. Next.
Shalanda. Hey, J times two.
Hey, Shalanda. How are you?
Lauren, did you say something?
I said, hey, Shalanda.
Oh, I'm like hearing things. Lauren, thank you both, Jay and Jay. You guys are changing lives, people and dogs every day. Can't tell how much I appreciate what you do and the knowledge you share.
Lauren, thank you so much for the kind words. Next.
Kara, are there any other arousal signs when my dog, reactive dog, sees another? I correct as soon as I see her ears focus on the other dog. Results in dog yelling. I usually have to correct more than once.
Yeah, you do have an audible dog. Arousal signs, dog gets a hard on. That's always a true one. What I would do is this, is if anybody wants a screenshot, that face she just made,
God.
if anybody wants to watch this on the replay, this is at 43 minutes. It was 42 minutes and about 50 seconds.
Are you watching my reaction?
I just noticed it out of the corner of my eye. Screenshot that, send it to me. That's a great face that she just made, a face of total disgust. While she was like looking at me like that. That was a beautiful one. We'll come up with a meme on that one. What I want you to do is this. So any change in the dog. So all of a sudden, yes, ears go up. It can do a couple of things. It can go from a mouth closed to mouth open. A mouth open to closed. Chest out a little bit. All right?
What do I do?
Okay.
Wow.
So what I would do is this. How does your dog do with leash pressure on a slip lead or a martingale? The prong collar is not hurting him. For all the folks out there saying, it's because the prong collar is hurting the dog. No, it's not. It's not. So what you can do is you can do a slip lead prong collar combo. Also, did you introduce the collar to the dog properly? Watch my video. Make sure you do that inside the house. I would get that dog used to it inside the house first. It's all that is your dog's massive dramatic no, but I don't know what your skill set is. I've seen people with really poor leash handling skills, which everybody can improve. And it's like your leash handling skills need to improve. That's what the problem is. Like we saw it at my seminar by one client. Remember that client? And I just said to her, all I literally want you to do is take your arm from here to there. All of it stopped. Mm-hmm. All of that stopped. Literally, it stopped. Mm-hmm. If we all had better leash handling, our dogs would actually do better on the leash. Next.
So true. Svenja, yes, the dog guards the other dog.
So you're going to teach that dog the out command. Remote collar on the dog. Teach the dog the out command. Out means get out of here. So you're going to need some help on this at first. Put a leash on the dog. Remote collars on the dog. You walk up to the client dog. And your dog tries to guard it. You say out, stim the dog at a pretty high level. The person holding the leash moves the dog away from you just to give it some directional control. And then the out means literally get out of here. Next.
Chevy, thanks, guys. Love your work.
Thank you.
Adelie, do you have a minimum age for T3? Would you allow a 16 or 17-year-old to attend?
Yes, we would. So no, we don't. Yes, you can come. But I'm going to want to talk to you first. Next. Because so you're going to have a problem with you have to stay at a hotel. So someone's got to book your hotel for you. And then that's the biggest thing. That's the biggest thing. Yeah. You've been to T3. Mm-hmm. Yeah. If you go there at 16 or 17, you're way ahead of the game.
Way ahead of the game.
Way ahead of the game.
Alisa, yes, with all the help of your videos, previous owners gave up on this dog 3 months ago. Now he is the best behaved dog, sending my love to you and your family.
I've said it once. I've said it twice. I've said it hundreds of times. Alyssa did this in 90 days by watching my free content. So can everybody else. So can everybody else. She's obviously been busting her ass. I'm sure it was not easy. She just wanted it so bad. She made it happen. Next. Mm-hmm.
Shalanda, how can we stop our 13-year-old from shutting down when he has the e-collar on trails? He's his normal self, but at home he'll sit, sulk. John will remove when he sulks and will act normal.
John's what, the husband?
I'm assuming, or her boyfriend.
Her boyfriend, Shalanda? So John's the shiny white in armor. The white, mm-hmm. What's it called?
The knight in shining armor.
The knight in shiny armor. Look at John swooping down off horseback, saving the dog. All right, John, get back on your fucking horse and get out of the fucking room. All right? This is what we're going to do. Your dog's playing you. Your dog is totally playing you. You want to sulk? You sulk. Let's get moving, buddy. Just run the dog through the commands. Run the dog through the commands. Next.
Let's see. Marion retracted her message. Princess. Hey, Jeff, do you backpack anymore? I just started a few years ago. Always thinking about where I'm going next. Dog loves it too.
No, I do not. But I'm going to kayak this spring and summer. Next.
Michael, thanks, Jeff. I'll give that a try. Thanks for all your videos. I love the prong collar for my sister-in-law's dog. It's worked wonders.
Awesome.
Blake. What age can I use a bark collar?
I'd like to try it at 16 weeks and up. And get yourself a Garmin one or e-collar technology one. Next.
Shalanda put laughing emojis.
There you go. See that? Shalanda knows. She's like, yeah, you pegged him right. You pegged John right. Mm-hmm.
Chevy, see you later, guys. Off to get some ice cream at the beach. I'm sorry. I just picture him as this nomad who never wears a shirt. He's super tan. He just wanders around New Zealand with his dogs.
That's what everybody in New Zealand does.
He lives the dream life.
Yep. Nobody.
What do you do, Chevy?
So
isn't he an artist too?
So nobody in New Zealand works, is what you're saying.
No.
Have you ever thought?
I didn't say everybody. I said him.
But have you actually ever thought that people for all we know, he's at work now watching this.
Off to get some ice cream at the beach.
He's on his break.
Chevy, what do you do? He's going to travel in his freaking RV. I need to know. I want to live that life.
Okay.
Well, Take me with you.
So you do travel in an RV. Next.
Oh, my God. Shalanda says it's never real to John unless it comes from your mouth. Thanks, guys.
Okay. John, listen to Shalanda. She knows what she's talking about. Okay?
Mm-hmm. She does.
Listen to her. She knows what she's talking about. probably not just dog training, but everything else.
Kaylee J says she would love to go to T3, hoping maybe next year or 2021.
Yeah, that'd be good, Kaylee J. Start saving up money. Why don't you do this? Get yourself a freaking hat, put it on the street, bring your dog and do tricks on the street for change.
Seriously.
You'll make all kinds of cash. Mm-hmm. And I'm 100% serious. Kaylee J, with a dog like that, you should be busking. Come on now. Busking. One of my daughters busks. My knife maker daughter will busk. She's a musician. She'll busk and then she'll do performances. And then she bangs out metal all day long. Next.
Svenja says, thank you.
You're welcome.
Bugging out 45. Thank you for your free videos. I started a prong collar on my 1-year-old pit mix. What an incredible difference it has made. Walking her is now a pleasure. Thank you.
You're welcome. I can't imagine some of these big bully breeds not using prongs on them.
I saw this huge American bulldog like dragging this guy today on my way to the gym.
I know.
Like dragging.
It's so incredible. It's like, what makes you?
I would not want to walk my dog.
What makes you use a harness?
No, it's not a flat.
Okay. But all these, you know what it is? A lot of these rescues and all these like pit bull groups are like, it has to have a harness on. Like there's a rescue in Rhode Island that when you adopt the pit bull, it wears a harness and they make sure that they tell you it will always have two leashes on it. One from the back, one from the front. Oh my I'm like, God. What? They're against tools. I'm like, what do you guys, like, do you have any fucking idea what it's like to have a trained dog?
Yeah. No, they don't.
So today I was just giving a great example about, like, people talking about, like, you know, leash laws and things like that. I took, did you watch the live? Do you have time to watch the live today? Mm-hmm. Or did you watch any of the stories? I did today on Instagram.
No, I didn't watch that.
So I took Clover to music class today and it started pouring rain. And I'm like, ooh, can I get to the center? That's what I was going to do. I was going to go to the center, run the dogs, and then come back and get her. And I'm like, I never gonna have enough time. It was over in East Providence. And then all of a sudden I see this big, huge field right next to the parking lot of the music school. So one of my daughters she's in a group at the Rhode Island Philharmonic Music School. And I was just like, chuck it. So I parked right there and I played chuck it right there. And then I just did a quick live and I'm like, guys, like when you have an off-leash trained dog, everywhere's your dog park. Mm-hmm. Like, and all these people are like leash laws. Like I was in East Providence has leash laws. Who's going to bother me there? It's private property. It's an open field. Like nobody's using it for anything. It's like right next to a drainage ditch. And then it's right next to like these woods. It's just space that's a buffer zone between like this building and the next building. Like nobody walks through it.
Yeah.
Nobody would want to walk through this area anyway. But it's just like, it's a great place to run dogs. Mm-hmm. And that's the thing is like any place. When we're on the road, I can't tell you, like, by the way, so we leave when? Thursday night? Mm-hmm. We leave Thursday night for 12 days. Make sure you jump onto our IG stories because we document everything. But you'll see me play Chuck It literally in a parking lot somewhere. Like sometimes we go to the gym so we'll park at Planet Fitness. Sometimes in the Planet Fitness parking lot, like I'll be like, let me just run my dogs right here. Mm-hmm. Like there's a huge parking lot. There's enough space anywhere's your dog park. So that's what I want people to have with their lives, with their dogs. It's just amazing where people are like, the dog has to have like all this, you know, this harness on with leashes and can never be off leash.
Yeah.
Next.
That's like, oh, will the dog ever get off an e-collar? It's like, will they ever get off a harness? Carrie, I think, is that where I am now? My dog's reactivity made us prisoners in our home. 1 month with your videos, we are out walking. Man, stuff keeps bumping me. I'm so sorry. Amazing results with behavior as a whole. Thank you guys so much.
Yep. There you go. Prisoner in our own home. Mm-hmm. That's what a lot of folks just don't get. They don't. Everyone's worried about the dog. Oh my God, the dog. Is it afraid? Is it fearful? Da, 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 da. It's like, I'm not gonna discount that, guys. But I'm saying it's like, who has that? Marion?
Carrie, I think.
Carrie?
Yeah.
How about fucking Carrie? Prisoner in her own home. How about her pain? That's what we should be worried about is her pain. Mm-hmm. If Carrie's not happy, nobody's happy.
Yep. We had a new one-on-one today. He said his arm hurts every time he walked his dog.
Yeah.
You should have seen how happy they were just walking around the center.
Yep. Next.
Zach, do you know how to get a metal coloring out of dog hair? My pith prong is leaving metal residue.
Oh, yeah. You got to just get yourself a hypoallergenic, a nickel-free collar. I don't know how to do that. I would talk to a groomer. Next.
Michelle, when I rescued my pit mastiff, I had to buy their harness. He outgrew it in 3 weeks.
Yeah, that happens. Next.
Doug H. in Virginia. Rescue group women are the most resistant to anything, any training class that I've ever seen over the past 20 years training and doing rescue stand handling. Why is that?
We don't want to stereotype just women, Doug, but I get what you're saying. Historically, rescue is primarily female. My audience is 80-90% female. I would say 99% of my haters are female. And a lot of it is based because they're used, unfortunately, people are using emotional based thought process where rational thinking needs to take place. And you can't substitute emotions for rational thought, where that's where we get, you know, thoughts don't care about, you know, facts don't care about your feelings. So that's probably what it is. A lot of people are also using the, what's the right word? I don't want to say the atrocities of their past, but a lot of people are using the personal history of their own personal past with authority figures and then really struggling with being the authority figure of their dog because they're humanizing what they went through. So it's really interesting. It's really the people aspect of this whole thing is interesting. Next.
What is that noise outside?
That's a dog barking.
Oh, it doesn't even sound like a dog,
it's,
though.
It's the dog's over there.
Sounds like a strange animal.
Yeah, dog's over there, yeah.
Let's see, Marion. I just ordered a prong collar and shock collar for my 4-year-old Great Dane male, and I can't wait to use it. He is such a dick. We are from Germany and just moved to the U.S. a year ago.
Oh, V. Gates. Next.
Cassandra, regarding my question of intent, just wonder if any dog with a bite history is considered aggressive. I've seen dogs attacked and never bite back, but in other situations, chase dogs away and nip at them.
Okay, well, chasing a dog. Okay, if my dog gets attacked and it bites back, I'm not going to consider myself my dog aggressive. Like, I'm not a violent person, but if I have to protect myself or my family, I'll be violent. But I'm not a violent person. But I will use an act of violence if I have to. But I'm not like, I don't handle my daily things through violence or bullying or arguing. I'm actually a very passive person, very reasonable person. But also there's a time and a place. And when it comes to my family or the people that I care about deeply or myself, theoretically all bets are off. So that would make me a violent person. So I think, you know, a dog that is, if somebody walks into your home and an invited guest and your dog races up to them and bites them, that is an act of aggression. So we can say that dog did have intent to harm. The intent was to harm. So we can call that aggression. So reactivity, there's no biting. So that makes it really easy. What's reactivity? There's no biting at all. Next.
Lauren, could you post a video of a heel tap?
Watch any of Caesar's shows. Just watch all of Caesar Milan stuff. You'll see heel taps. Next.
Christopher, thanks, Jeff. Bonker fixed treat guarding, only did it twice. Now she drops it on command first time.
Look at that, Christopher.
Did you just do that in the same show? Just went and did it, and look at that.
I don't know.
Pam, I'm so frustrated. No matter what I do on walks, prong collar, leash pops, e-collar stims, pre-walk bonks, I can't get this dog to walk calmly by the fence running dog gauntlet. See you in Vegas.
Well, Pam, that's probably the hardest thing to do. Now, this is the thing, Pam. When you struggle, when some of my clients struggle, and some people I see at seminars struggle, there's just lack of information that they have. There's lack of timing. So for instance, the last seminar in Atlanta, there was people there that had remote collars on their dogs, had prong collars on their dogs, were doing all of the stuff they see in my videos, but for some reason they still weren't getting it. So after the weekend and after I coached them, they got it. Because there's a skill, there is a skill set to all this stuff. It's not just, it's sort of like this. You can be a baker and I can be a non-baker and I can even have a recipe in front of me. I can even watch a video on how to make, say, a cake. And we both use the same ingredients. We both use the exact same oven, so there's no temperature fluctuations, so we can't blame the oven temperature fluctuations. And your cake most likely will come out better than my cake because the baker has a skill set. There are some nuances to it. Next.
Good analogy. Rebecca, my dogs are off leash trained, but I worry about someone calling animal control. Have you ever had that happen? How do you handle that type of situation?
Rebecca, I've never had it happen. And if it happened, I'd be like, okay, sorry. I mean, believe it or not, when your dog is, there's a huge difference, guys, to having a trained in control dog on leash and off leash. There's a very big difference between that and having a dog at large and out of and not in control. So if animal control approached me and they saw me playing Chuck It with my three dogs, I highly doubt they would come barging out of their cars yelling and screaming at me. They most likely would drive up. First of all, they're on private property, so they can't, but let's pretend they could. They would drive up and they would roll down their window and they would say, "Hey, Jeff, hey, what's up?" And they're probably like, "We love your videos." I'm like, "Thanks." So, but let's pretend they didn't know. Let's pretend they didn't know me. They would say, "Hey, you know, we really need your dogs to be on leash." I'll say, "Oh, okay, no problem at all. Just want to exercise my dogs. Thanks a lot." And I would be respectful. I wouldn't be like, "Well, actually, my dogs are, you know, under voice control and I've got the right to be here." I'd be like, "Okay, cool." Next.
I'm bugging out. LOL, when I was in line at Petco with my pit mix, a man was literally dragged in by his pit bull. I yelled out to him that he needs a prong collar. Now I'm a cheerleader for prong collars. Jeez.
Bugging out.
I'm sure he loved it.
Stay in your lane, buddy. Stay in your lane. Stay. Don't be an ambulance chasing dog trainer. Just don't do that. I don't do that. I walk by dogs badly behaved all the time. I'm just like, yep, there's another badly behaved dogs. It's so funny. People are like, "Do you hand out business cards?" I don't even own business cards. No. It's like, no. And if I did, I wouldn't. If you want help with your dog, there's a thing called Google. You can find help. You can find help. Next.
Mm-hmm. NF, reformed dog rescuer, and they're really bad about putting their feelings on dogs. You are so right, Jeff. We'll see you in Ohio.
I know. See you in Ohio there. Canton, Ohio, guys. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. Next.
Let's see. Tokaj. Hi, Jay.
Hey, Tokaj.
Today it happened. Again, off-leash dog ran straight into us. My dog instantly wrestled him down, but without teeth. I stopped scenario with e-collar. Other dog was fine. I just scared one day it will get real.
So get yourself some bear spray, Tokaj. Get yourself some bear spray. Go to REI or Eastern Mountain Sports. Get yourself some bear spray or go to a gun shop. They might not have them there. A hunting shop with Bass Pro Shops, Cabela. Get some bear spray. Neutralize the threat. Got it? No hesitation. No hesitation. Practice it. Okay? Practice. Practice the motion. Got it? Just pay attention to the wind. Bear spray, you got a little bit more flexibility because it's designed to spray far, where mace is designed to spray in close quarters. So the spray pattern is different. You're gonna be really worried about the wind. Okay. And just neutralize the threat. Next.
New Zealand Kiwi, raising dogs outdoors in New Zealand compared to raising dogs indoors in Montreal is How would you compromise and adapt with different training styles when you're helping raise a 6-month pup?
Trust me, man. I love when I was in Australia Everybody's got outside dogs. These dogs, all the houses are set up for outside dog living. Mm. It's so nice. They've got these huge, everyone's got these big patios, you know, enclosed areas. They put out big, everyone's got fenced in yards that are really good fencing. They've got huge water buckets. They've got fans. And it's like, it's a great life. Mm. It's just great. Yep, it's really, really nice. So what I would do is I would still want that dog under voice control. I would still do all my on-leash and off-leash obedience. I'd want my dog to be off-leash trained as quick as possible, living in New Zealand, unless you lived in like, you know, a major city where your dog's always on-leash, but you can go out to, you know, New Zealand's got so much open space. So what would I do differently? Probably not much at this age. Next.
Beverly, I was walking my 10-month-old German Shepherd and a pit bull charged us. I was lucky to have a man driving by that stopped to help us. What should I do if this happens again? Can I pepper spray the pit?
Yeah, but it's not just the pit, Bev. Any dog charging you. Yeah, you can always do that. You have to neutralize the threat. Dogs are getting killed, maimed, harmed. Owners are getting bit on walks by off-leash dogs. It sucks. Dog pays the price, but if a dog has to pay the price, I don't want it to be mine. Next.
Mm-hmm. Tokaj. Okay, I'll advocate for my dog now, straight up.
Thank you, Tokaj.
That's it right now.
That's all we got.
I think we screwed up the freaking notification today again because we did that YouTube live. So I don't know if anyone got notifications for the show.
Oh, because we did too many of them. Oh, shit. Mm. Oh,
because I didn't get one.
Really? Mm-hmm. You didn't get a reminder? Mm-mm. Oh.
That's probably what happened.
Oh shoot! That's the last time I'll do one on the day of a show.
I think we did it. I think we did it Wednesday too.
Did we really?
We boosted that that bonker video you put out of that leash reactive dog, the one we did in Florida. Not Florida. Where were we just last?
We were in Atlanta.
Atlanta. And we were like, oh, we got to put that out on YouTube. So I had Amanda put it up.
Oh.
It bumped our notifications.
So we had too many. We had too many videos get loaded in one day.
Yep.
I wonder if there's a workaround on that.
I know.
There has to be a workaround. Yeah, there's got to be a workaround.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, everybody's saying they got notified. I didn't. Okay, well, that's good.
Yeah, everybody here, they got notified.
Yeah, true. Maybe not everyone did.
Yes.
Gonzalo. Jeff, this is Gonzalo. It was a pleasure to speak with you yesterday.
Oh, Gonzalo, how are you? It was great to speak with you. I'm really proud of you, buddy. You're doing great stuff.
All right, everybody got notifications, okay. I guess. Marty Cool Dog.
So everybody but you.
I always use my phone clock alarm.
What did I do? Am I in your ban list or something? It's like...
I have access to the damn channel.
It's like...
I'm pretty sure I'm subscribed to you.
Jeff's always sending me texts of things to do. The last thing I want to do is get notified about the show.
Yep, unsubscribe.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm pretty sure I'm subscribed. God,
How can I get every other text from Jeff? Because then I'll have half the workload.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but then I'll be like, hold on, why isn't this shit done yet? You'll be like, oh, is that the stuff that I didn't get?
Oh, I never got the text. Never got the notification. Oh man. Danny says did not get it, but I watched the early show. Thanks. See, something's going on here.
Something's going on.
Yep.
That's okay. We can always have an earlier show.
Yeah.
Yep. You do anything for I gotta go you wanna give me a ride down to Walgreens?
Sure.
Are you in a rush to get home? Mm-mm. I gotta go to Walgreens so I just don't have to pull my car out. Let's go to Walgreens. I gotta pick up plastic eggs and stuff to put inside the eggs for an Easter egg hunt for
nice.
Angelo.
Cute.
Yeah, for tomorrow. He's nice. The only one that's going to do it. We're going to find him a little basket.
Nice.
Yeah. So.
Walgreens. Yep.
Next.
Nia, dog clips water bowl despite any applied punisher. Do I confiscate water bowls and go to hung bottles?
You forgot Lisa Fati.
Where?
Dog gets car sick.
Oh, sorry, Lisa. My stuff's all jacked up right now. Dog gets car sick. Barfed in my car shifter. Oh, my God. Disgusting, 6 months old. I use lots of structure. What else can I do?
Lisa, get your fucking dog in a crate in the back seat. That's for sure. So I would get your dog in the back seat. I'd put your dog into a down in the back seat of the car. Also, are you doing a lot of duration stuff? Car sickness, we fix just through our basic obedience duration, permission-based leadership training program. We actually don't address car sickness. Now, there are some holistic methods you can use. There are some herbs or some oils you can use. I'm not against those at all, but I just don't have the knowledge base on those. Next. I get an itch on my nose.
I see that.
Next.
You're on camera.
I don't care.
Tokaj got notified.
Yep.
Nia, dog flips water bowl despite any applied punisher. Do I confiscate water bowls and go to hung bottles?
You can also do a bucket.
I think that's what she means, like a hung bucket.
Just get a pail and hang it. Next.
Donovan, at what age can I expect my 5-month-old pit bull to be obedient? Right now, sometimes he listens really well and others not at all. It's like he tries to test me when he knows better.
So Donovan, if you keep doing what you're doing now, it'll be 10 years. So at 5 months old, number one, how is there a leash on your dog? And are you doing training with your dog daily on training drills? Sits. How many times a day are you practicing your sits, your downs, your place, in and out of the crate, recall, proper heel, duration work, permission-based stuff, waiting for food, stopping unwanted behaviors? It's a 5-month-old dog. So your average 5-month-old dog, even with that, only has a certain level of obedience training. But it's not as it gets older. It's, okay, yes, as it gets older, if you're doing the work, it will get better. But if you're not doing the work, and I'm talking a lot of work, it's not going to get better. It won't get better. Next.
Do you want me to read this next one?
Sure.
Al Devo, can we have perfect training results in dog training using only positive methods? Love
for no. First of all, the short answer. Okay, let me just think. Inside in an enclosed area with no distractions or a highly controlled area, you can absolutely obedience train your dog using positive reinforcements. But there is no such thing as all positive reinforcements. There's every dog is applied a punisher multiple times a day, even though people don't know they're doing that. But no, you cannot have a reliably trained dog in the real world with only positive reinforcements. It's impossible. It's a scam. And it's a marketing ploy that should stop. It's a message that needs to be stopped. And people have to realize that a correction or a punisher is not a bad thing. It's not abuse. The problem is that social justice warriors have taken over and hate groups have taken over dog training. But anybody that can show me a dog from start to finish, and you'd have to document every day of its life to prove it. But all dogs get a consequence for making a bad choice. Just putting a leash on the dog is a punisher because it keeps the dog from moving freely. So it's impossible. It can't be done. Anybody that says so is a liar. They are a liar. Next.
Lauren, I hear you, Tokaj. Today, when we got run up on, I couldn't get between my girl and the loose dog to kick it. I'm scared about the bear spray too. Might spray my girl's husband says to run with a bat.
Probably a bat's probably too heavy. Maybe a hiking stick or a baton or a retractable baton. But I would just get bear spray. Next.
Dirt and Soul, strategies to speed up e-collar recall. One of my dogs gets distracted and the other is unsure and not very motivated. Thank you.
So the one that's unsure, not very motivated, go back to basics, long line on, give the dog more direction. As far as speeding it up, you can start increasing the level of the stim. Also, make sure you're training with lots of food. Next.
Natalie, 8-month Dane has growled a few times as a pup. Last week, he snapped at a girl at the vet giving him a treat. She was at his level in his face. My fault. Is high level correction the way to deal with it?
No. So Natalie, thanks for owning up on that. That is 100% your fault. Absolutely. Absolutely. I would never, first of all, it's not acceptable. The dog does not get a free pass. Like, let's put that out there right now. But a separate conversation is I would never, ever allow anybody, I don't allow people to approach my dogs at all. But at a vet, I would never allow anybody to approach my dog, ever. And this concept that coming up with a food source to a dog means that the person is friendly or that the dog will be nice, as you found out today, isn't the truth. But you can't correct your dog at a vet office. What you do is you have to stop that from happening. So you go into the vet office, you put your dog in a down, and no dog comes up to it, and no people come up to it. Okay, next.
Top chat.
Marisol, how do you decide that a dog won't improve on his fear, shut down, pressure makes it worse, I put pressure and weight, but becomes more aggressive, I have decent handling skills, and he bit me twice. That is such a hard question to answer, because I don't know your skill set at all. I'd have to see you working the dog. I would need to, okay. I've only met one dog, the dog we just had a few months ago that we mentioned in the seminar. Mm-hmm. One dog that was just, the chances of that dog resembling anything close to a normal dog outside of its own property is pretty slim. The amount of fear that dog had was incredible. In the house, it's doing fine. In the backyard, it's doing fine. Environmentals outside, it's overtaken with fear. That's one out of thousands. So there's so many things you need to do with a fearful dog. And a lot of it is putting pressure on it. And that's what blows people's minds. And what's pressure? You're demanding of the dog, a lot of remote collar work. And you can use fear to rehabilitate fear, because you can't use rewards because the dog won't take them. People have to understand what fear means too. It's getting the dog out of its comfort zone. So you're creating fear in the dog to combat its own fear. Next.
Randy, so I started feeding raw and he's not eating the chicken liver. Should I replace it with beef liver?
Try. Yeah. I mean, I don't know how the dogs know the fucking difference.
My dogs are super weird with organ at first, though.
Really?
I have to feed it half frozen because the texture.
No. Oh. The two of you got texture issues, so does the dog.
Go figure,
yeah,
right?
Go figure. Yeah. Wes whines and you don't.
I don't.
No.
Natalie. And muzzle conditioning. I've applied all of your training. Going awesome.
Good.
Danny, so you don't think a timeout will work?
Where's that?
Danny,
timeouts don't work. Timeouts don't work at all. I don't time out my kids. I don't time out my dogs. I correct a dog. Now we move on with life. I don't have time for timeouts. I don't have time. And dogs don't give safe spots either. Next.
Blake, how long does it take for a new behavior to become established long-term?
Oh, thousands of reps. Thousands of reps. So, I mean, clicker work, it's like, I don't know, 2,000, 3,000 reps of something. Next.
Blake, how long does it take? Oh, I just
that one already. Yep.
Julie, do you believe feeding raw can change a dog's temperament for the better? Not talking severe aggression, just a noticeable difference.
Temperament? I don't know about temperament. We see better health problems, better teeth issues. You get better teeth issues. So cutting down on ear infections, gum issues, teeth issues, losing weight,
better skin,
better coat.
Make it feel better. Sure.
Dogs feel better, but so overall, yeah, we see stuff.
Raphael, I carry a stun baton when I walk my dogs with a side of pepper spray. Shit.
Raphael?
With a side of pepper spray.
There you go.
It's a deadly cocktail.
That's right, it is.
Anthony, I have 12-week-old GSD. He only likes walking off-leash. Even with a prong collar, he just sits.
I wouldn't probably put a prong collar on a 12-week-old dog right now. Also, don't worry about the walk. I want you to work on your sit, your down, your place, in and out of the crate, do your recall, all food. We that's all clicker training and food training. All clicker food. If you don't want to use a clicker, use a marker. All marker and food-based training right there. The walk, no problem at all. Don't be in a rush to take your dog off property with a prong. Next.
Danny says, being sarcastic.
Oh, good.
We knew.
I didn't.
Is that Danny?
I don't know. I'm not familiar with Danny.
Oh, me neither. But yeah. I wouldn't think that he would be serious on your show asking.
Some people, you'd be surprised. Some people are. They're right before they jump off.
Done. Yeah. They're like, let me troll this guy real quick. I'm out. Donde, you feed raw to your dogs?
I do. Tonight I fed duck.
Did you? Did they like it?
They loved it.
My dogs go nuts.
I know. How many do you give them? One or two, depending on the size?
I chop those into thirds, and then that's like their...
You do?
Mm-hmm.
They're small.
Oh, yeah. Don't feed as a whole meal. You can.
I know what I mean. They're small. Can. Oh, so you chop them into thirds, you add a little bit to each meal.
Yeah.
Oh, got it.
At what age do you recommend a prong collar, Anthony?
Anthony, I would go a couple more weeks, buddy. Just go to about 14 weeks, but also watch the introduction of the prong collar, Anthony. Watch how he introduce it. And you're going to do it inside. And you're going to get that dog to understand the pressure and then how to turn off the pressure. Very low impact. But as soon as you go outside, also your dog's going through a fear stage. So you got a couple of things working against you, right? So your dog's nervous as it is outside. So, but let's do that. And let's work on all your food, tons of food training. Like if this dog's on kibble, you know, a 12-week-old German Shepherd probably eats what? What is that? Two cups maybe it's on? Two cups, each cup maybe. We're talking like 200, 250 pieces of kibble a day, right? That's a lot of sits, downs, places, and recalls. Have that dog work for its food. Next.
Desiree, 8-month-old husky working on place. I can only work with him once a day after work. How long should I work on each day?
Desiree, as long as you have time for. The maximum amount of time you have. But Desiree, why don't you get up a little bit earlier in the morning? Come on. Want me to send you a text at 4 a.m. Eastern time? That's when I'm up. That's when I'm up. Ready to go. Mm-hmm. Ready to go. Notice how the sun's getting up.
It's so great.
The sun's so getting up.
It's light, dark. It's light later now.
I know. We're having longer days. We're having longer days. It's really
so
nice.
Awesome. Lisa, what website for info on feeding raw? Google.
Karmavore, right? K-A-R-M-A.
I website. I only try Instagram.
Try K-A-R-M-A, Karma, and then
Karmavore.
And then V-O. re.com. Try karmavore.com and tell them we sent you. Next.
Look at girl sleeping. She's like having a serious dream.
Yeah, she dreams. She's been dreaming her whole life. She's been having crazy dreams.
Like,
oh yeah, she does it all the time.
Desiree says Desiree's already up at 5 for work. LOL.
All right. Well, get up
at 4.
Get up. So okay, then get up at 4. So you get up at 4. You do a bunch of obedience, right? Next.
Lisa says thanks.
You're welcome.
Julie, by the way, I've been stalking your show for a while without saying anything. Your content is fantastic. Thanks so much. We get a lot of those.
So Julie, creepers. So Julie, what made you write that today? What inspired you to put a comment up there for the very first time? What was it?
Maybe because you aren't so scary tonight yelling at everyone. He's actually calm. So she's like, maybe now is my chance. So I don't get yelled at.
I never yell at people.
Bullshit. Check the Instagram feed. I put all the crazy ones up.
Yeah, but it's not yelling at people. That's just yelling to the, like, I'm yelling to the freaking window.
Okay. Desiree says, okay, I will try. All right, let us know on the next show if you got up at 4 a.m.
That's right.
It's worth it. Marisol, what are the first steps in training a fearful dog to accept touch? He bites his family members.
Oh, fuck. Now you stop. The first step is a high-level punisher. That's the first step. Fearful or not, I don't give a shit. So fearful biters don't get a free pass. Now, if you corner the dog and it bites you, it's like, okay, hold on here. Like, we're gonna work through that. But if I just go to reach for you and you bite me, like, fuck that. You get a punisher. So we stop that. Then step two is we do clicker, food, touch, counter conditioning. we'll do that. And that's a protocol. The first step, though, we have to be safe. We have to be safe. Yeah, this whole thing about fear doesn't give dogs a free pass. So if my dog is sitting down and I go to touch, if I go to touch it, to touch it, and it bites me, no. That's not acceptable. That's not acceptable. Next.
Julie, working my 10-month-old GSD in the yard with your tips and two people were seeing the noticeable difference. Only had her 2 months.
Awesome. Proud of you. Awesome. So proud of you.
Next. That's what made her want to write on your show, too.
Got it.
Florida, I have a 5-week-old puppy. What should I start training? 5 weeks old.
5 weeks old is really young. What happened? What happened with that dog at 5 weeks old? Can it get back to the breeder for 3 more weeks?
Oh my God, I watched the most.
Hold on, let me just finish this question. Florida, can you get that dog back to the breeder for a couple more weeks? Back with its litter, back with its mom for a couple more weeks? Could you try? That'd be really, really good. What should you start training? Let's try that first. That's really young for a dog. It's really, really young for a dog, to come out of its litter. The first things you do is everything. So all food stuff, probably going in and out of a crate, get to follow you around, which you'll do because you've got food. I don't even know if the dog's on solids yet. Probably. 5 weeks old. Probably, yeah. Like mush. You probably take food and put in water in it. Exactly. Yeah. Put water in it. Yeah. Samantha Block, Super Chat, $19.99. Thank you. Hey, Jeff, had to say thank you. I've watched and rewatched all your videos, use them to help mine, my friends, and family's dogs. They think I'm a wonder trainer now, but I always got to admit how I refer to all your videos. But Samantha, you're doing the work.
That's great.
You're doing the work, Samantha. So I'm glad I can be of help. But Samantha, let's call it like it is. You're the fucking superstar. Got it? Don't discount your skill set. Don't discount your knowledge. Don't discount the fucking effort you're making and the act of kindness and generosity that you're doing to help people. Like, don't discount that, okay? It's you. I'm a guy with a big fucking mouth. That's it. Next.
Dirt and Soul. Cool, I'll go back to move indoor recall. They're still on leash and long line.
Okay,
I'm sure our dog is inherently fearful and not food motivated, but she knows the commands, just takes her time.
So Dirt and Soul, believe it or not, fearful dogs that are not food motivated, we use remote collar for recall. Got it? We make it suck not to come back to us, but do a lot of reps first. Don't just go immediately go to that. But I'm just saying, in the big picture, I know you're afraid, but I'm your safe place. Next.
Rebecca, do you know how many spots are left for the Vegas seminar? Trying to save up.
Oh, Vegas is plenty. That's not until September. There's plenty.
Marisol, dog doesn't accept food. Tried to load the clicker and not interested. I cut his food to develop food drive. Still nothing.
So Marisol, are you feeding the dog out of a bowl? Only use food for training. Try that. Only use food for training. Next.
Florida says, Jeff, honestly, I found him in an abandoned dog litter and he's the only one who survived.
Okay, got it. No. That's why I didn't attack you. I always want to know. Like, put it this way. Claire.
I was just saying, those are the most social puppies ever.
Yes, but there's also 3 of them together.
Yeah.
Okay, so keep that in mind.
And she had her German Shepherd.
And she had a German Shepherd, and she also is an expert puppy raiser.
Yeah.
So Claire, who is one of our new hires, came to us with 3 puppies. She got it 6 hours old. It's 6 hours old. She's raised them, and now they're 8 weeks old?
Mm-hmm.
They're 8 weeks old, yeah. So...
Super social.
Yeah, super social, but there's 3 of them. Yeah. She had her dog, and she's also an expert puppy raiser. Next.
Trisha got a 10-month-old GSD. He keeps trying to kill the cat. He intensely stares at her, and no matter how high I shock him, he won't break the stare. Maybe for a second he will. How do you deal with this a lot?
Well, first of all,
do you deal with this?
Yes, I do. What brand of collar is it? How snug is it? Also, go to the bonker. Got it? I have 2 videos to watch, 3 videos to watch, all on YouTube. How to make a bonker, how to use the bonker, and then I did I just remember this, it's a 48-minute pop-up live that I did a couple of weeks ago. It looks like me in a hotel room because I was actually in a hotel room when I filmed it. And it's the bonker. And he stares at the cat. You say nice and calmly, no. And then as hard as you can, throw it, release it from your hand down on the dog. Yes, you hit the dog with it. Where? In the head region. You won't hurt the dog. All this stuff you hear about, like injuries and, you know, the dog being afraid of you and, you know, ruining the relationship and, you know, I would never throw anything at my dog. And I'm like, all this stuff. It's like, you just save your dog, cat's life. I mean, it works. Remember, no, nice and calmly, apply the Punisher. Next.
JJ, good live program. Lots of good info tonight.
JJ, thank you.
Miriam, we just got a four-month-old puppy yesterday. To resource guards, people, toys in the crate, what to do?
So resource guard, you have to stop that with no. If you're 16 weeks old, you better stop this today, actually. Tomorrow, you'll say no and you'll bonk. So let me give you a good idea, a good example. A toy. Get yourself a bonker like this. First of all, let me help you out even more than this, because this is going to be the last question that we're going to do. I'm going to end the show with this. First of all, I'm going to get to how to stop this, but I want to make sure you're being highly proactive in raising this dog right. Right now, with a dog with those behavioral issues, there should be no affection. Training is going to be your affection. Okay? Exercise will be your affection. Not giving the dog up will be your affection. In a crate at night. In a crate when you're not home. Do crate drills. Got it? Kettle up, come back out. Everything's on a leash. I want a leash on this dog unless it's in a crate for the time being. In and out of a crate, drills. Got it? Okay. No free roaming of this dog whatsoever. I want you to work on your sit, down, place, recall, all with food. Food and clicker. Use food to train the dog. What I don't want you to do is, I don't want you to do feed out of a bowl. Okay? You're going to be doing all that. Structured walk with the dog. Do that. Now, let the dog have a toy. You approach the toy. The dog says, the dog growls at you, resource guards. What I want you to do is I want you to say calmly, no. Throw this at the dog. You won't hurt the dog. I mean, 4 month old, unless it's a tiny chihuahua, you want to use a small one. So the dog's 20 pounds and up. Got it? You make it suck. Crate, same thing. Next. Oh, we're done with the show. Give me some show. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. It's been a good show. We're doing a show on Monday night. 8:30. Linda's the co-host. Monday night shows are at 8:30. Happy Easter, everybody, if you celebrate Easter. Passover, if you celebrate Passover. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. And that's it for the night. Anything to say?
That is all.
You done?
I was going to say, watch this YouTube video today on a mom golden retriever. Her eight puppies are going nuts. And she just like lay down the law, and every puppy just like lay down. It was so calm.
What did she
and
do?
So how, quiet.
How did she lay the law?
Oh my gosh, she just snapped at all of them. She was really? Like, harsh correction. 8 weeks old.
Yep.
And every single puppy like hit the deck and was like, alrighty then.
Yep.
A single one. Yep.
Punishment works.
Yep. Go figure.
Sure does.
She was a boss, and then they kept trying to like weasel their way over to her, and she'd like keep correcting them, and they finally were just like not making it.
She's probably tired of the sucking on the titties.
Tired of that shit.
It's like, my titties are sore.
Yeah, but it was just like, wow, like, look like, at this.
You don't know what I've been through.
Yeah, it's just incredible. Like, it's so important, like, those few weeks.
Yep. People don't know.
Yeah.
They don't, and it's not about us being the mother dog either. That I don't want to ever use that example, but no. It's about us. It's about us. It's about punishment works.
Yeah.
That's the message.
And they learn it from day one.
Yes. Like, punishment works. Mm-hmm. That's the way. Guys, National Geographic.
I have to share that on my Facebook.
Yes. Punishment works. Yeah. And nature is fucking cruel. Mm-hmm. Nature is very cruel.
Yeah.
Yep. Dogs learn from nature. Yep. I know. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. Take care.
Good night.